problem getting ABS. I need more modulation.
Yeah, first official on-track session with the new system. I mean, here at Indianapolis Motor Speedway, it's in a completely different beast.
Yeah, we got 10 minutes left to avoid it. Just get a call at the diff, and then we can get it back there and start working on it.
We're lacking a little bit of feel on the brakes right now.
You know, there's a lot of long straights with heavy braking zones, so I knew this would be kind of a different feeling and a new challenge for the system.
We have like zero decel. Like the brakes are glazed, or I just can't get any brake pressure. I don't know what's going on.
Okay, copy. We'll take a look at it.
Well, if I'm not confident after practice two, I'm going to have to find a way to be confident. Initial bite, like I pull the brake, frankly, as hard as I physically can, and I just like progressively decel. I don't get that like big like
bang.
So the brakes didn't feel the same as they did when we were testing in Putnam. So trying to rule out certain things to make sure that we understand if it was just the track, if it was possibly the calibration of the system.
I'm having a hard time like get my trail how I want it.
At Putnam, you did have that initial feel.
Oh, Putnam, yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So, might be hardware.
We'll get data and find out.
You know, there's a lot of different variables, but potentially something just wasn't gelling perfectly right, but I wasn't really confident in the brake zones. And it's something that, yeah, we need to sort out quickly because we only get one more practice session before quali in the race. So, that's where everyone's kind of taking a look at right now, make sure everything's as it should. And if it is, then I just have to adapt to the feeling and we'll move on with it. But before I start chasing a ghost that maybe doesn't exist, I want to rule out certain variables from the equation.
Gary, let's do three laps.
One of the most impressive things right away with Robert when he got back in the car, it was clear he hadn't lost his pace. He hadn't lost his desire to drive fast right away. The discussion wasn't about the hand control. It was about him wanting to go faster and tuning the car. Robert's won a championship, and we know, we see in the data, there's been limitations to what our old system could do. But already we can see the Bosch system overcomes those challenges. And I'm 100% sure this is going to open up a lot of new opportunity for Robert to be even more competitive and maybe see him in different types of cars too.
There are some other maps that might be worth trying, but I think it's more mechanical than anything else at this point.
I'm not changing anything for the race.
Okay, copy.
So we're in the Bosch Trackside Support Center. It's our truck that we take to each IMSA race. Out of this truck, we run all the IMSA scrutineering, the hybrid system for the IMSA series, and then for hand controls, we're operating out of here this weekend with the rest of our team. So Jordan's in the pits with the team, and we're back here. And the reasoning behind that is we can't have telemetry on the stand in the Michelin Pilot Challenge. And so that's why back here, looking at data, looking for the diagnostics on the system. And then Jordan's there with the team in the event there is an issue, we'll relay information to Jordan and tell him what's going on. Because it is a really safety critical system when you think about brakes. You can test as much as you want, but no one's gonna run a car as hard as it will at a racetrack until they're with other cars at a racetrack. And so it's been really, really well from this perspective. For the most part, pulling data, looking at it, pretty good, sending it back out.
So if we don't have any heating issues or whatever, then sitting here, then we'll wait the 6 minutes just as planned. Okay, let's go ahead.
Bit, red flag.
Fine, you guys, it's just a car pulled off the side. What the?
I was told if we go green, I'm not allowed to run a lap because we're not allowed to line up in red during qualifying, I guess. So that's a new one for me.
Copy that. Sorry, buddy. My fault. Yeah, we've covered the back before.
Do you want to see Daddy's race car?
Yeah.
Come see.
Do you want to leave your waffle here?
Just leave your waffle behind.
I'm super excited to be here, honestly. I've been working in motorsport for a little over 8 years now, and I've never done a project like this before.
I've always seen motorsports, especially endurance sports car racing, as a place to prove out new technology. Our relationship with Bosch, for example, started out with very basic data logging opportunities to maintain the competition parity that we have with so much variety and so many manufacturers. Now this, taking the next step in what I believe is absolutely a monumental movement to support full hand control system for a driver like Robert to take the next step in his career.
I've always had ambitions of trying to have the opportunity to explore the possibilities of racing in WeatherTech or even other professional categories around the world, frankly. So what this does is, you know, it's not a guarantee by any stretch of the imagination, but it does give me a chance.
He's super driven and super motivated, that's clear. And he is a way of kind of pulling that out of the people around him too. I think that's something that I think is kind of special about him, is that he makes all of us also want to do our best as well.
He's worked extremely hard to get to this point. Bosch has worked extremely hard to now take the system that he has been using up several notches. My hope would be that he can take the next step in his development and his perseverance and his story at the highest levels of sports car racing.
With the help of Bosch, we've now created an electric brake system that we can take from car to car, from paddock to paddock, and then give myself further opportunities for my motorsport career.
Feeling really good, you know, kind of got unlucky in qualifying with the red flag and whatnot, but we've started back here before and made our way to the front, so we just got to do it again.
Yeah, so all through practice, everything was going well. The system's doing what we think it should. We're continuing to make small improvements, but here we are on the grid for the race, and now we get to see what we have.
Yeah, we had some hiccups with the ABS, just kind of a little too active, I guess, is a way to put it, but that's all figured out and sorted, so looking forward to this race.
Do what you gotta do.
All the hard work of getting to this point, and now we're finally ready to race it, so it's an exciting time for everyone involved. I'm going to be getting into the car second, so I'll be finishing the race, and hopefully we can fight for a win here in a little bit.
All I got to do is keep the race car clean, get in the top five area, give Robert a nice race car to go finish it off, and that should be good.
Let's be ready, be ready, be ready. Green, green, green.
That was not the most neat and tidy start, and already a problem.
Full course yellow, full course yellow.
In TCR, Morgan Burkhardt, Victor Gonzalez, Hyundai Elantra leads from the Hyundai N coloured cars. The three of them are 98, 33 and 77. Mark Wilkins, Harry Gottsager, Taylor Hagler.
Let's try to get in on the early side of it.
Yeah.
Like if there's a shunt and the pits are still open, we should try beat it in.
Yeah. Sure. Yeah. Can I talk about that?
I'll get dressed.
One, 1.18 Fahrenheit on the track. 90 in the air translates to 48 Celsius on the track. 32 in the air. Oh my goodness me. The number 99, the leader in TCR.
Harry, we're 43 minutes into this deal, so I think we're going to do the driver change and take advantage of this yellow. Hey, everybody, we're stopping with Wader, full fuel, topper off.
Today marks another milestone for Robert Wickens. This is the first race with that new Bosch package. So this allows you possibly another opportunity to continue to chase your dreams. It also allows other people to actually have a dream.
Well, it's been down the road when once I can hang up my helmet, hopefully I've created an easier, more accessible way into motorsport. You know, build a bit of an even a curriculum, if you would, on how adaptive motorsport
can go, from starting in karting all the way up to the highest levels of motorsport. And to show to anyone with a disability that there is technology in motorsport that can allow you to do anything you want.
Pushing the limits of the brake pedal. That's my biggest struggle right then. Track's super dirty. You can see just watching all the dirt flying up and everything. We had good brakes compared to the other rest of the field, but yeah, it's definitely the heat is a big, you know, an obstacle in this situation right now.
Reset fuel, hour 9 left.
Copy, radio check, fuel's reset.
Got out in second, and now we are in fourth. Had a little hiccup in the pit stop, but nothing too bad. We can work from here for sure. We got some fuel to save till the end, and that's one of Robert's specialties, so it'll be an exciting finish.
The 33, Robert Wickens, I think, following the same strategy as well, trying to save as much fuel as he can, running in the 10th position overall, and second in TCR.
Okay for 172, fuel number 172.
I'm more concerned at tires at this point. 169.
Eight minutes to go, plus 36 seconds to P3.
So it'll be a 1-2 for Brian Herd at Autosport, and they go wild.
Me too, buddy. Good job. Great job. Great job.
Yeah, good job, guys.
Congrats, buddy. 1-2. All right.
1-2 at Indy.
And from our system perspective, it was green lights across the board the entire time. So the system had no faults the entire time. It was reliable. We were monitoring the data stream back in the truck. I got no reports of any issues. I got no reports on the radio of anything related to brakes. Could not have gone better from our standpoint. And the car finished P2, so.
The important thing for me was, unlike my system in the past, I had the same consistent, familiar brake every single time I applied the brake throughout the race.
Give it up for the drivers of car number 33, Harry Dotsacker and Robert Wickens!
Felt like I could just pull the brake, and I got the exact amount that I was expecting, so it was just nice to find a rhythm and find good pace that way too. And I still think this is just the beginning. You know, this is only race one of my Bosch EBS, and I'm hoping that for many more, hundreds more, right? And having a proven braking system that I can take from car to car speaks volumes, and all I want to be is evaluated as a normal driver, like I was in the past.
This is a type of project, like mechanical engineer gets like once in a lifetime. I don't know if it'll sink in quite yet, but it's really special to be a part of this project. Couldn't be happier. We're not done yet.